have a couple of songs here named after women, Gloria and Georgia. In fact, they both called in and requested that today. It's a
there you go.
Normal duty here. Ramondo and Evans. And Monkees, Steppin' Stone.
Mm-hmm.
Haven't heard that for a while.
No.
And the Stones start me up. Boomtown Rats, the live version of I Don't Like Mondays. And Don't You Want Me, Baby, the Human League here. It's 8:20 and time for...
Radio Neighbor.
Today's Radio Neighbor is...
a guy by the name of Charlie who used to work at KROQ, and some people think of him as a fish.
Charlie Tuna on K-Hits on K-Rock coming up.
Yes.
Charlie.
Yeah.
Ramondo and Evans with Radio Neighbors.
Hi, Radio Neighbors.
How you doing today?
I'm fair to partly cloudy.
There you go. You know, you've been around doing mornings in L.A. for a long time. We have a question, a very important question. You could be a big help to us, Charlie. How do you go about getting a raise in this business?
You leave the station, but I don't think you want to, do you?
Not really.
That's a fun place to work, Charlie. You ought to try it sometime.
You know, well, I did. As a matter of fact, you're talking to an historical figure with KROQ.
Charlie Tuna worked at K-Rock?
Originally at the AM.
You're kidding.
I was the first disc jockey to broadcast on K-Rock.
You're kidding.
Oh, I heard about that. You had a limousine take you to work.
No, I couldn't find a place to park in Burbank, though, when I was originally located there.
Now, I have a question for you. I've always wondered there, a Radio Neighbor. Where'd you get your name?
They gave that to me, when was it, back in 1966. Well, I have two answers. One is, if you look at all the names, like Wolfman Jack and Machine Gun Kelly... That was the only one left at that point. The original one was a newsman back in Oklahoma City in 66 at a station there at KOMA. And he had to go on the air one time on a Sunday morning show, didn't want to use his own news name to diminish the integrity of his journalistic ability. So as a consequence, picked out a name he saw in the commercial. The Charlie Da Tuna commercial went on the air. It's Charlie Tuna. I got there the next week to start the job. They said, you're going to be the permanent one. I said, you're kidding. And it stuck.
All right.
So then they named the seafood after you.
Yeah. Well, I work for scale, too. That's part of it.
Hey, of all the music, different types of music you've played, Charlie, what do you like the best?
I really like what I play right now, as a matter of fact.
Oh, they all
I mean,
say that.
That may sound trite and cliche, but people say, gee, how can you stand that stuff? I really enjoy it. One of the reasons is because I don't have to listen to it. I can turn the monitors down.
There you go. There you go. Hey, listen, do you have any TV projects coming up or anything?
Oh, well, I've been doing some announcing for some TV shows, and a commercial comes along every now and then. You go for what you get in this business, but that's basically it. I'm very happy doing what I'm doing, and I do the American Forces show every day, too, that goes around the world, and I get a lot of feedback on that from people when they come back here to the States. But it's, I hate to think of the prospect when I have to grow up and start working for a living.
Yeah, I hear you. Charlie, listen, it's great having you on our Radio Neighbor show, and sometimes we'll stop over there on the way in early and have some coffee with you.
By the way, I have some old K-Rock jingles if you ever want to revive those from back in 1972 when I worked there.
Oh, absolutely.
Yeah, we'll take you up on that, Charlie.
All right. Thanks, neighbors.
Thanks. Bye-bye.
Thank you. Bye.
What a nice guy.
Yeah.
Well, what a nice guy.
All of us disc jockeys are nice guys.
Charlie Tuna, K-Hits. Thank you.
Charlie on KROQ-FM. We forgot to ask him something.
About his eyes?
Yeah. What's he got in his eyes when he's on that TV commercial? I guess we all do that, don't we?
Get up!
There's a waitress's KROQ FM.
And take off.